I can assure you, there are no such things as monsters.
Oh, yeah? Look!
I'm back.
Quick, get behind me, boys! Don't look her in the mole. I mean, the eyes.
Mr. Mosby?
Miss Schickelgruber, my girl?
Actually, since you had me fired from the Tipton organization, I've gotten married.
You're kidding.
No. My married name is Ilsa Schickelgrubermeiger hyphen von Helsing der Kepi Lugerhofer.
You're kidding.
That must take forever to write on your underwear.
I have a stamp.
But that's not my only happy news. I have become the manager of the St. Mark Hotel across the street.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
And I will not rest until the Tipton is a parking lot and you are parking the cars.
Mr. Mosby, that was awesome. You weren't scared at all. Mr. Mosby?
Too many walnuts, he'll lock himself in the bathroom and cry.
Cookies are amazing. You know, girls like guys who can cook.
I helped!
Mmm, these are fantastic! How much are they?
They're free, for $5.
I'll take the whole basket.
All right! Cody's cookies are going to make me rich!
Did I say me? I meant us.
I see our dental conventioners appreciate the sugarless gum.
Well, 4 out of 5 of them do.
funny.
Oh, hey! Would you watch where you're going?
I'm so sorry.
No, it was my fault.
Forgive me for staring, but your teeth. They're like perfect little pearls.
Oh, thanks. You're kind of cute yourself. For a dentist.
I wish. My dream is to attend the Zurich Dental Institute and make the world safe from chronic periodontitis.
I don't know what you just said, but it sounds so... medical.
Mosby? Yeah, I just wanted to see if the Japanese ambassador had checked in yet. Oh, wait! He couldn't have, because he's staying at the St. Mark.
That's impossible. He always stays here at the Tipton.
Oh, it seems he heard you were having a problem with cockerlockers. That's German for cockroaches!
Well, he must have heard that lie from the head cockalocker herself.
Oh. It's Ilsa.
You know her?
Yeah, she runs my dad's hotel across the street. If he finds out I'm here, I'll be in big trouble.
You're Todd St. Mark? I'm London Tipton. My dad hates your dad.
My dad hates your dad?
We have so much in common.
Todd! Oh, good hiding place. It was so hard to see you behind the 4-foot Cupid doll.
You know your father doesn't approve of your dental dream. Orbs, Tipton. It is verboten. Come with me, much schnell.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. Left, left. Don't look back. Left, left.
Is it true that you two are selling unauthorized cookies in my hotel?
Nope, no truth whatsoever.
Mm-hmm. Then why is the kitchen a mess?
Mom's a slob.
I'm a what?
Job. You're doing a great job as a single mom. I mean, look at us. We're adorable.
You two are absolutely forbidden from selling unauthorized cookies in my lobby.
You could serve Cody's cookies at the Beacon Hill Ball. You know how those society types like designer cookies.
I'll take 500.
Done. Not done. I'm cookied out.
Zack, your brother's tired.
Thanks, Mom. I don't even want to look at another stove.
What about the one in the hotel kitchen?
You mean the Samurai 5000? With stainless steel convection ovens and computerized temperature controls?
Oh, not to mention our tungsten cooling racks.
Honey, you need to rest.
Stay out of this, Mom. You were doing so well right up to the wall.
I've been text messaging with Todd for the past 24 hours.
Why don't you just go over to the St. Mark?
I'd never make it past Ilsa. There's nowhere we can meet where fathers won't find out.
This is so romantic.
Oh, what you two need
is a secret romantic hideaway.
The laundry room. This is your idea of romantic? No wonder you don't get dates.
Hey, it was either this or the men's room on the third floor.
I love it.
London. Oh, thank goodness you're still here. Sorry I'm late, but I couldn't get away from Ilsa's watchdog blitzkrieg.
Is he a German shepherd? Doberman?
Dachshund. Nasty little thing. I'd fight my way through 100 wiener dogs to see you.
My hero.
Maddie, thank you so much for setting this up for us. And in return, when I become a dentist, I'll fix that overbite.
Some people think it's cute.
I've enjoyed our cyber conversations, but it is so nice to actually be with you.
I know. Now when you tell me a joke, instead of typing LOL, I can actually LOL.
I love your LOL.
I love finally being alone with you.
Any machines free? I have to do my delicate.
Mosby! Where is he? I know he's here.
He who?
You know he who?
No, who he?
My who he!
Huh?
Oh, stop with your silly word games. Todd, he snuck out.
Oh, you've lost Todd. Which, by the way, isn't the only thing that you've lost. It turns out that the Beacon Hill Masquerade Ball will now be held at the Tipton.
Nonsense. That ball's been held at the St. Mark's for over 30 years.
Not anymore. We stole it from you.
Oh, Mr. Mosby, dance while you can. I don't think Mr. Tipton will be very happy when he finds out his precious daughter is dating Todd St. Mark. They've been in constant communication. Where are they?
I assure you, I have no idea. Maddie, have you seen London and Todd?
Nope, haven't seen him. Not at all nearsighting. See ya!
Okay, they're on the roof!
I can't say I approve of your methods, but they are effective.
Enough of the yak-yak! To the roof! Left! Left! Don't look back! Left!
My doctor says if I should stay away from chocolate and younger men.
Aren't you supposed to be working?
What's your point?
I pictured this moment differently. But I have to tell you something.
Yes, Todd?
London, I...
Elsa's here!
Gotta go.
Nice boy. But he doesn't say much.
He was about to. Todd!
London!
London!
Todd! Maddie! Per your father's orders, I am locking you in your room, taking away all your communication devices and your giant plastic tooth.
No, not Tommy Tooth.
Yeah, and Frida Floss. Let's go.
London! London, look. If I allowed you to see this St. Mark boy, your father would have my head, not to mention my job.
Look, I don't care. I can't believe Daddy had Mosby confining me to my room.
Don't worry. You'll see Todd again someday. Of course, he'll be a dentist, so you'll have to make an appointment.
This is the most tragical thing that's ever happened to me.
Well, you know what Shakespeare said? The course of true love never did run smooth.
Huh?
Love sticks.
Oh, I know. This is just so unfair. I always get everything I want.
Did you get everything you ever wanted for Christmas? Everything you wanted for your birthday?
And Hanukkah.
You can't get gifts on Hanukkah. You're not Jewish.
And miss out on 8 days of presents? Not this chic stuff.
I just miss Todd so much.
London!
I mean, sometimes, it's like I can hear his voice. It's Todd with a bullhorn.
What soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and London is the sun.
Oh, he's quoting Shakespeare. I thought Shakespeare was your friend. He's a writer. Romeo and Juliet. In a poetic way, Todd's saying that he loves you.
Oh, okay, tell me how to say I love you too in Shakespeare talk.
My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love as deep.
Got it. I love you too, sweet cheeks.
That's true, right?
He can't hear me. And I can't leave my room. Maddie, will you go tell him?
Sure.
Wait. I want to give him something. What's romantical? A lock of your hair. Perfect.
Todd, London says she loves you and wants you to have this.
This isn't all of it, is it?
No. Then I shall treasure it always. Give her this, and tell her that it is but a token of my love for her.
Gotcha! Todd says this is a token of his love.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Here, give him this. And tell him, ditto. Okay.
for something better.
Can you keep it under 80 pounds?
Yes.
Okay, but I'm not passing it on.
You know, you're right. It's just not the same.
Wait, I got it. Tomorrow night is the Beacon Hill Masquerade Ball. Get a costume and a mask, sneak over, and I'll have Lennon meet you there.
That's perfect. Uh-oh. It's Blitzkrieg.
Yes, that would never happen at the Saint Mark. Enjoy.
Oh, I thought I smelled a rat, but it turns out it was a mole.
What mole?
Do you own a mirror?
Come on, they've already run out of cookies at the ball.
Boy, those skinny rich people can really chow down.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. This one I did it for love. Now I'm doing it for money and I feel dirty.
Wipe your filth off with this 20 and get back to work.
Why aren't you working? Why don't you help out and separate some eggs for me?
Done. Cooking is easy.
I'll whip this up a batch.
So Todd really wanted to kiss me? No, he wanted to kiss the plant.
Why would he want to kiss the plant?
He doesn't. He wants to kiss you.
So Todd really wanted to kiss me?
It's a special night. Don't make me slap you.
So, which one is Todd?
The one in the mask.
Oh, that narrows it down.
First batch. You baked a hockey puck. You could break a tooth on one of these.
So what? There are 200 dentists in the lobby.
Yeah, but when people eat a Cody's cookie, they expect it to melt in their mouth, not break their bicuspids.
Todd, you're in there. Sorry, picked the wrong nose. Not yet.
I don't need any more of your help. Just keep out of my way and stay over there.
Did you just flick flour in my face?
Maybe I did, maybe I didn't.
Well, maybe I flicked some back.
Maybe I didn't. Well, I know you didn't. Because if you did, I would have done this. And that's how you separate an egg.
This is how you separate a pie from its pan.
He wouldn't. He would.
I love the twins.
This pie throwing will stop this instant.
Mr. Moosby.
Right after this.
Cody! Oh, what
in here. Oh! Yeah, of course. Oh! That I didn't see coming.
I need to tell you that I love you and do this.
I guess some people do get everything they want. Happy Hanukkah, London.
Your father is on the phone, and he wishes to speak to you. Yeah!
So I guess you're gonna lock me in my room now, huh?
I'm sure that's what your father would want.
Good. If I can't see Todd, I might as well spend the rest of my life in my room.
You really like this boy, don't you?
I would love him even if you were poor.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, in that case, if you want to see Todd, it's not up to me to stop you.
But won't you get in trouble with my father?
Sometimes when you care about someone, you have to think of them before yourself.
Thanks, Mosby.
That was so sweet. It makes me want to puke!
Yeah, okay, Dad. Bye.
Bad news?
My dad said I could go to dental school in Zurich.
That's great.
No, it means I'll be away from you. Which is exactly why he said it. He'd rather have me scraping teeth than be with a Tipton.
Oh, I see.
So, I turned him down.
You did? But it's your dream. What about all those poor people with pterygodactylitis?
I'd rather have you.
Oh, Todd. Oh, that's the most wonderful thing anyone's ever done for me. And I won't let you do it.
What about us?
Sometimes when you care about someone, you have to think of them before yourself.
It'll only take me 8 years to become a dentist. Then I can see you.
Can we make it a morning appointment?
Absolutely.
That was really wonderful, London. Maddie, that Romeo and Juliet book has a happy ending, right?
Yeah!
Cody, don't you have something to say to your brother?
I'm sorry I flicked flour in your face.
Zack?
I'm sorry you're my brother.
Zack!
I'm sorry I worked you like a pack mule. I was just thinking of the money. Lots and lots of money! Bag loads of money!
Zack!
Sorry. It's okay that you wanted to make money off my cookies. But I just need time to make them just right. And 75% of the profits. 40! 50! Done.
Okay, but I get 10% of both your cuts.
Done.
It's not worth it. Happy when he finds out his precious daughter is dating Todd St. Mark. They've been in constant communication. Where are they?
I assure you, I have no idea. Maddie, have you seen London and Todd?
No, haven't seen. I'm not at all nary sighting. See ya. Okay, they're on the roof.
I can't say I approve of your methods, but they are effective.
Enough of the yak-yak! To the roof! Left! Left! Don't look back! Left!
My doctor says I should stay away from chocolate and younger men.
Aren't you supposed to be working?
What's your point?
I pictured this moment differently. But I have to tell you something.
Yes, Todd?
London, I...
Elsa's here!
Gotta go.
Nice boy. But he doesn't say much.
He was about to. Todd!
London! London!
Todd! Maddie! Per your father's orders, I am locking you in your room, taking away all your communication devices and your giant plastic tooth.
No, not Tommy Tooth.
Yeah, and Frida Floss. Let's go.
London! London, look. If I allowed you to see this St. Mark boy, your father would have my head, not to mention my job.
Look, I don't care.
I can't believe Daddy had Mosby confining me to my room.
Don't worry, you'll see Todd again someday. Of course, he'll be a dentist, so you'll have to make an appointment.
This is the most tragical thing that's ever happened to me.
Well, you know what Shakespeare said? The course of true love never did run smooth.
Huh?
Love sticks.
Oh, I know. You think this is just so unfair. I always get everything I want.
Did you get everything you ever wanted for Christmas? Everything you wanted for your birthday?
And Hanukkah.
You can't get gifts on Hanukkah. You're not Jewish.
And miss out on 8 days of presents? Not this chic stuff.
I see our dental conventioners appreciate the sugarless gum.
Well, 4 out of 5 of them do.
funny.
Oh. Hey! Would you watch where you're going?
I'm so sorry.
No, it was my fault.
Forgive me for staring, but your teeth. They're like perfect little pearls.
Oh, thanks. You're kind of cute yourself. For a dentist.
I wish. My dream is to attend the Zurich Dental Institute and make the world safe from chronic periodontitis.
I don't know what you just said, but it sounds so medical.
Mosby? Yeah, I just wanted to see if the Japanese ambassador had checked in yet. Oh, wait! He couldn't have, because he's staying at the St. Mark.
That's impossible. He always stays here at the Tipton.
Oh, it seems he heard you were having a problem with cockalockers. That's German for cockroaches!
Well, he must have heard that lie from the head cockalocker herself.
Oh. It's Ilsa.
You know her?
Yeah, she runs my dad's hotel across the street. If he finds out I'm here, I'll be in big trouble.
You taught St. Mark? I'm London Tipton. My dad hates your dad.
My dad hates your dad.
We have so much in common.
Todd! Oh, good hiding place. It was so hard to see you behind the 4-foot Cupid doll. You know your father doesn't approve of your dental dream. Or the Tipton. It is verboten. Come with me. Much schnell.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. Left. Left. Don't look back. Left. Left. Left.
Is it true that you two were selling unauthorized cookies in my hotel?
Nope. No truth whatsoever.
Mm-hmm. Then why is the kitchen a mess?
Mom's a slob.
I'm a what?
Job. You're doing a great job as a single mom. I mean, look at us. We're adorable.
You two are absolutely forbidden from selling unauthorized cookies in my lobby.
You could serve Cody's cookies at the Beacon Hill Ball. You know how those society types like designer cookies.
I'll take 500.
Done. Not done. I'm cookied out.
Zack, your brother's tired.
Thanks, Mom. I don't even want to look at another stove.
What about the one in the hotel kitchen?
You mean the Samurai 5000? With stainless steel convection ovens and Christmas tots so much.
I mean, sometimes, it's like I can hear his voice. It's Todd with a bullhorn.
What's that? What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and London is the sun.
Oh, he's quoting Shakespeare.
I thought Shakespeare was your friend.
He's a writer. Romeo and Juliet.
In a poetic way, Todd's saying that he loves you.
Oh, okay, tell me how to say I love you too in Shakespeare talk.
My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love as deep.
Got it. I love you too, sweet cheeks.
That's true, right?
He can't hear me. And I can't leave my room. Maddie, will you go tell him?
Sure.
Wait. I want to give him something. What's romantical? A lock of your hair. Perfect.
Todd, London says she loves you and wants you to have this.
This isn't all of it, is it?
No.
Then I shall treasure it always. Give her this, and tell her that it is but a token of my love for her.
Gotcha.
Todd says this is a token of his love. Oh, that is so sweet.
Here, give him this. And tell him, ditto.
Okay.
I have to give her something better.
Can you keep it under 80 pounds?
Yes.
Okay, but I'm not passing it on.
right. It's just not the same.
Computerized temperature controls?
Well, not to mention our tungsten cooling racks.
Honey, you need to rest.
Stay out of this, Mom.
Right up to the wall.
I've been text messaging with Todd for the past 24 hours.
Why don't you just go over to the St. Mark?
I'd never make it past Ilsa. There's nowhere we can meet where fathers won't find out. This is so romantic.
Oh, what you two need
is a secret romantic hideaway.
The laundry room. This is your idea of romantic? No wonder you don't get dates.
Hey, it was either this or the men's room on the third floor.
I love it.
London. Oh, thank goodness you're still here. Sorry I'm late, but I couldn't get away from Ilsa's watchdog blitzkrieg.
Is he a German shepherd? Doberman?
Dachshund. Nasty little thing. I'd fight my way through 100 wiener dogs to see you.
My hero.
Maddie, thank you so much for setting this up for us. And in return, when I become a dentist, I'll fix that overbite.
Some people think it's cute.
I've enjoyed our cyber conversations, but it is so nice to actually be with you.
I know. Now when you tell me a joke, instead of typing LOL, I can actually LOL.
I love your LOL.
I love finally being alone with you.
Any machine free? I have to do my delicate.
Mosby! Where is he? I know he's here.
He who?
You know he who?
No, who he?
My who he!
Huh?
Oh, stop with your silly word games. Todd, he snuck out.
Oh, you've lost Todd. Which, by the way, isn't the only thing that you've lost. It turns out that the Beacon Hill Masquerade Ball will now be held at the Dipton.
Nonsense. That ball's been held at the St. Mark's for over 30 years.
Not anymore. We stole it from you.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, Mr. Mosby, dance well you can. I don't think Mr. Tipton will be very...
Mr. Mosby! It's a hideous monster, and it's coming this way!
Boys, I can assure you, there are no such things as monsters.
Oh, yeah? Look!
I'm back.
Quick, get behind me, boys! Don't look her in the mole. I mean, the eyes.
Mr. Mosby?
Miss Schickelgruber, my girl?
Actually, since you had me fired from the Tipton organization, I've gotten married.
You're kidding.
No. My married name is Ilsa Schickelgrubermeiger hyphen von Helsing der Kepi Lugerhofer.
You're kidding.
That must take forever to write on your underwear.
I have a stamp. But that's not my only happy news. I have become the manager of the St. Mark Hotel across the street.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. And I will not rest until the Tipton is a parking lot and you are parking the cars.
Mr. Mosby, that was awesome. You weren't scared at all. Mr. Mosby?
careful. If you tell him there are too many walnuts, he'll lock himself in the bathroom and cry.
Cody, these are amazing. You know, girls like guys who can cook.
I helped!
These are fantastic! How much are they?
They're free! For $5.
I'll take the whole basket.
All right! Cody's cookies are going to make me rich! Did I say me? I meant us.
Boys, I can assure you, there are no such things as monsters.
Oh, yeah? Look!
I'm back.
Quick, get behind me, boys! Don't look her in the mole. I mean, the eyes.
Mr. Mosby?
Miss Schickelgruber, my girl?
Actually, since you had me fired from the Tipton organization, I've gotten married.
You're kidding.
No. My married name is Ilsa Schickelgrubermeiger hyphen von Helsing der Kepilugerhofer.
You're kidding.
That must take forever to write on your underwear.
I have a stamp. But that's not my only happy news. I have become the manager of the St. Mark Hotel across the street.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. And I will not rest until the Tipton is a parking lot and you are parking the cars.
Mr. Mosby, that was awesome. You weren't scared at all. Mr. Mosby? He'll lock himself in the bathroom and cry.
Cody, these are amazing. You know, girls like guys who can cook.
I helped!
These are fantastic! How much are they?
They're free! For $5.
I'll take the whole basket.
All right! Cody's cookies are going to make me rich! Did I say me? I meant us.
I see our dental conventioneers appreciate the sugarless gum.
Well, 4 out of 5 of them do.
Funny. Hey! Would you watch where you're going?
I'm so sorry.
No, it was my fault.
Forgive me for staring, but your teeth. They're like perfect little pearls.
Oh, thanks. You're kind of cute yourself. For a dentist.
I wish. My dream is to attend the Zurich Dental Institute and make the world safe from chronic periodontitis.
I don't know what you just said, but it sounds so... medical.
Mosby? Yeah, I just wanted to see if the Japanese ambassador had checked in yet. Oh, wait! He couldn't have, because he's staying at the St. Mark.
That's impossible. He always stays here at the Tipton.
Oh, it seems he heard you were having a problem with cockalockers. That's German for cockroaches!
Well, he must have heard that lie from the head cockalocker herself.
Oh. It's Ilsa.
You know her?
Yeah, she runs my dad's hotel across the street. If he finds out I'm here, I'll be in big trouble.
You're Todd St. Mark? I'm London Tipton. My dad hates your dad.
My dad hates your dad.
We have so much in common.
Todd! Oh, good hiding place. It was so hard to see you behind the 4-foot Cupid doll. You know your father doesn't approve of your dental dream. Or the Tipton. It is verboten. Come with me, Mark Schnell.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. Left. Left. Don't look back. Left. Left. Left.
Is it true that you two were selling unauthorized cookies in my hotel?
Nope, no truth whatsoever.
Mm-hmm. Then why is the kitchen a mess?
Mom's a slob.
I'm a what?
Job. You're doing a great job as a single mom. I mean, look at us. We're adorable.
You two are absolutely forbidden from selling unauthorized cookies in my lobby.
You could serve Cody's cookies at the Beacon Hill Ball. You know how those society types like designer cookies.
I'll take 500.
Done. Not done. I'm cookied out.
Zack, your brother's tired.
Thanks, Mom. I don't even want to look at another stove.
What about the one in the hotel kitchen?
You mean the Samurai 5000? With stainless steel convection ovens and computerized temperature controls?
Oh, not to mention our tungsten cooling racks.
Honey, you need to rest.
Stay out of this, Mom.
You were doing so well right up to the wall.
I've been text messaging with Todd for the past 24 hours.
Why?
Todd! Oh, you did come!
Of course I did. I needed to tell you that I love you. And do this.
On the phone, and he wishes to speak to you. Yeah!
So I guess you're gonna lock me in my room now, huh?
I'm sure that's what your father would want.
Good. If I can't see Todd, I might as well spend the rest of my life in my room.
Hey, you really like this boy, don't you?
I would love him even if he were poor.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, in that case, if you want to see Todd, it's not up to me to stop you.
But won't you get in trouble with my father?
Sometimes when you care about someone, you have to think of them before yourself.
Thanks, Mosby.
That was so sweet. It makes me want to puke!
Yeah, okay, Dad. Bye.
Bad news?
Well, my dad said I could go to dental school in Zurich.
That's great.
No, it means I'll be away from you. Which is exactly why he said it. He'd rather have me scraping teeth than be with a Tipton.
Oh, I see.
So, I turned him down.
You did? But it's your dream. What about all those poor people with pterygodactylitis?
I'd rather have you.
Oh, Todd. Oh, that's the most wonderful thing anyone's ever done for me. And I won't let you do it.
What about us?
Sometimes when you care about someone, you have to think of them before yourself.
It'll only take me 8 years to become a dentist. Then I can see you.
Can we make it a morning appointment?
Absolutely.
That was really wonderful, London. Maddie. That Romeo and Juliet book has a happy ending, right?
Cody, don't you have something to say to your brother?
I'm sorry I flicked flour in your face.
Zack?
I'm sorry you're my brother.
Zack!
I'm sorry I worked you like a pack mule. I was just thinking of the money. Lots and lots of money! Bag loads of money!
Zack!
Sorry. It's okay that you wanted to make money off my cookies. But I just need time to make them just right. And 75% of the profits. 40, 50, done.
Okay, but I get 10% of both your cuts.
Done.
It's not worth it. Happy when he finds out his precious daughter is dating Todd St. Mark. They've been in constant communication. Where are they?
I assure you, I have no idea. Maddie, have you seen London and Todd?
No, I haven't seen him. Not at all. Nary sighting. See ya. Okay, they're on the roof.
I can't say I approve of your methods, but they are effective.
Enough of the yak. To the roof! Left! Left! Don't look back! Left!
My doctor says I should stay away from chocolate and younger men.
Aren't you supposed to be working?
What's your point?
I pictured this moment differently. But I have to tell you something.
Yes, Todd?
London, I...
Elsa's here!
Gotta go.
Nice boy. But he doesn't say much.
He was about to.
Todd!
London! London!
Todd!
Maddie!
Per your father's orders, I am locking you in your room, taking away all your communication devices, and... your giant plastic tooth.
No, not Tommy Tooth.
Yeah, on Frida Floss. Let's go.
London! Oh, God, London, London, look. If I allowed you to see this St. Mark boy, your father would have my head, not to mention my job.
Look, I don't care.
London says she loves you and wants you to have this.
This isn't all of it, is it?
No.
then I shall treasure it always. Give her this, and tell her that it is but a token of my love for her.
Gotcha! Todd says this is a token of his love. Oh, that is so sweet. Here, give him this. And tell him, ditto. Okay.
Give her something better.
Can you keep it under 80 pounds?
A kiss.
Okay, but I'm not passing it on.
You know, you're right. It's just not the same.
Wait, I got it. Tomorrow night is the Beacon Hill Masquerade Ball. Get a costume and a mask, sneak over, and I'll have Lennon meet you there.
That's perfect. Uh-oh. It's Blitzkrieg.
Smelled a rat, but it turns out it was a mole.
What mole?
Do you own a mirror?
Come on, they've already run out of cookies at the ball. Boy, those skinny rich people can really chow down. Let's go, let's go, let's go. You know, I used to like this when I did it for love. Now I'm doing it for money and I feel dirty. Wipe your filth off with this 20 and get back to work. Where are you working? Why don't you help out and separate some eggs for me? Done. Cooking is easy. I'll whip this up a batch.
So Todd really wanted to kiss me?
No, he wanted to kiss the plant.
Why would he want to kiss the plant?
He doesn't. He wants to kiss you.
So Todd really wanted to kiss me?
It's a special night. Don't make me slap you.
So, which one is Todd?
The one in the mask.
Oh, that narrows it down.
Okay, here's my first batch. Baked a hockey puck. You could break a tooth on one of these.
So what? There are 200 dentists in the lobby.
Yeah, but when people eat a Cody's cookie, they expect it to melt in their mouth, not break their bicuspids.
Todd, you're in there. Sorry, picked the wrong nose. Not here.
I don't need any more of your help. Just keep out of my way and stay over there. Did you just flick flour in my face? Maybe I did. Maybe I didn't. Well, maybe I flicked some back. And maybe I didn't. I know you didn't, because if you did, I would have done this. And that's how you separate an egg. This
you separate a pie from its pan. Come back here and take this banana cream pie like a man.
He wouldn't. He would.
I love the twins.
This pie throwing will stop this instant.
Mr. Moosby.
Right after this.
Won't find out. This is so romantic.
Oh, what you two need
is a secret romantic hideaway.
The laundry room. This is your idea of romantic? No wonder you don't get dates.
Hey, it was either this or the men's room on the third floor.
I love it.
London. Oh, thank goodness you're still here. Sorry I'm late, but I couldn't get away from Ilsa's watchdog blitzkrieg.
Is he a German Shepherd? Doberman?
Dachshund. Nasty little thing. I'd fight my way through 100 wiener dogs to see you.
My hero.
Maddie, thank you so much for setting this up for us. And in return, when I become a dentist, I'll fix that overbite.
Some people think it's
cute.
I've enjoyed our cyber conversations, but it is so nice to actually be with you.
I know. Now when you tell me a joke, instead of typing LOL, I can actually LOL.
I love your LOL.
I love finally being alone with you.
Any machine free? I have to do my delicate.
Moosby! Where is he? I know he's here.
He who?
You know he who?
No, who he?
My who he!
Huh?
Oh, stop with your silly word games. Todd, he snuck out.
Oh, you've lost Todd. Which, by the way, isn't the only thing that you've lost. It turns out that the Beacon Hill Masquerade Ball will now be held at the Dipton.
Nonsense. That ball's been held at the St. Mark's for over 30 years.
Not anymore. We stole it from you.
Oh, Mr. Moosby, dance while you can. I don't think Mr. Tipton will be very happy when he finds out his precious daughter is dating Todd St. Mark. They've been in constant communication. Where are they?
I assure you, I have no idea. Maddie, have you seen London and Todd?
Nope, haven't seen him. Not at all. Nary sighting. See ya.
Okay, they're on the roof.
I can't say I approve of your methods, but they are effective.
Enough of the yak-yak. To the roof. Left. Left. Don't look back. Left.
My doctor says I should stay away from chocolate and younger men.
Aren't you supposed to be working?
What's your point?
I pictured this moment differently. But I have to tell you something.
Yes, Todd?
London, I...
Elsa's here!
Gotta go.
Nice boy. But he doesn't say much.
He was about to. Todd!
London!
London!
Todd!
Maddie!
Per your father's orders, I am locking you in your room, taking away all your communication devices and your giant plastic tooth.
No, not Tommy Tooth.
Yeah, and Frida Floss. Let's go.
London! London, look. If I allowed you to see this St. Mark boy, your father would have my head, not to mention my job.
Look, I don't care.
Confining me to my room.
Don't worry. You'll see Todd again someday. Of course, he'll be a dentist, so you'll have to make an appointment.
This is the most tragical thing that's ever happened to me.
Well, you know what Shakespeare said? The course of true love never did run smooth.
Huh?
Love sticks.
Oh, I know. This is just so unfair. I always get everything I want.
So you get everything you ever wanted for Christmas? Everything you wanted for your birthday?
And Hanukkah.
You can't get gifts on Hanukkah. You're not Jewish.
And miss out on 8 days of presents?
Not this chic stuff.
I just miss Todd so much. I mean, sometimes, it's like I can hear his voice.
It's Todd with a bullhorn.
What saw it? What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and London is the sun.
Oh, he's quoting Shakespeare.
I thought Shakespeare was your friend. He's a writer. Romeo and Juliet.
In a poetic way, Todd's saying that he loves you.
Okay, tell me how to say I love you too in Shakespeare talk.
My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love as deep.
Got it.
I love you too, sweet cheeks!
That's true, right?
He can't hear me. And I can't leave my room. Maddie, will you go tell him?
Sure. Wait, I want to give him something.
What's romantical?
A lock of your hair.
Perfect!
Confining me to my room.
Don't worry. You'll see Todd again someday. Of course, he'll be a dentist, so you'll have to make an appointment.
This is the most tragical thing that's ever happened to me.
Well, you know what Shakespeare said? The course of true love never did run smooth.
Huh?
Love sticks.
Oh, I know. This is just so unfair. I always get everything I want.
So you get everything you ever wanted for Christmas? Everything you wanted for your birthday?
And Hanukkah.
You can't get gifts on Hanukkah. You're not Jewish.
And miss out on 8 days of presents?
Not this chic stuff.
see our dental conventioneers appreciate the sugarless gum.
Well, 4 out of 5 of them do.
Funny. Hey! Would you watch where you're going?
I'm so sorry.
No, it was my fault.
Forgive me for staring, but your teeth. They're like perfect little pearls.
Oh, thanks. You're kind of cute yourself. For a dentist.
I wish. My dream is to attend the Zurich Dental Institute and make the world safe from chronic periodontitis.
I don't know what you just said, but it sounds so medical.
Mosby? Yeah, I just wanted to see if the Japanese ambassador had checked in yet. Oh, wait, he couldn't have because he's staying at the St. Mark.
That's impossible. He always stays here at the Tipton.
Oh, it seems he heard you for having a problem with cockalockers. That's German for cockroaches!
Well, he must have heard that lie from the head cockalocker herself.
Oh. It's Ilsa.
You know her?
Yeah, she runs my dad's hotel across the street. If he finds out I'm here, I'll be in big trouble.
You taught St. Mark? I'm London Tipton. My dad hates your dad.
My dad hates your dad.
We have so much in common.
Todd! Oh, good hiding place. It was so hard to see you behind the 4-foot Cupid doll. You know your father doesn't approve of your dental dream. Or the Tipton. It is verboten. Come with me, much schnell.
What?
Dot. Left. Don't look back! Left!
Is it true that you two are selling unauthorized cookies in my hotel?
Nope, no truth whatsoever.
Then why is the kitchen a mess?
Mom's a slob.
I'm a what?
Job. You're doing a great job as a single mom. I mean, look at us. We're adorable.
You two are absolutely forbidden from selling unauthorized cookies in my lobby.
You could serve Cody's cookies at the Beacon Hill Ball. You know how those society types like designer cookies.
I'll take 500.
Done. Not done. I'm cookied out.
Zack, your brother's tired.
Thanks, Mom. I don't even want to look at another stove.
What about the one in the hotel kitchen?
You mean the Samurai 5000? With stainless steel convection ovens and Christmas tots so much.
London!
I mean, sometimes, it's like I can hear his voice.
It's Todd with a bullhorn.
What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and London is the sun.
Oh, he's quoting Shakespeare.
I thought Shakespeare was your friend.
He's a writer. Romeo and Juliet. In a poetic way, Todd's saying that he loves you.
Oh.
Okay, tell me how to say I love you too in Shakespeare talk.
My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love as deep.
Got it.
I love you too, sweet cheeks.
Oh, you're right.
He can't hear me. And I can't leave my room. Maddie, will you go tell him?
Sure. Wait. I want to give him something. What's romantical?
A lock of your hair.
Perfect.
Todd, Lennon says she loves you and wants you to have this.
This isn't all of it, is it?
No.
Then I shall treasure it always. Give her this, and tell her that it is but a token of my love for her.
Gotcha!